long did it take you to get here?
If you're interested, if you've not heard of these before, last year in the West Bottoms, we had 562 teams. This year out here, we've got a total of 618 teams. Square footage-wise, I think we increased by about 80,000 square feet. So, growth is not our objective. We're not intending for this to keep going, but it's nice to have those options, and it's nice to be able to accommodate people in a great setting. One last word, the American Royal, our most successful event is you all, it's our barbecue. But during the 3 months of the fall, we do 30-some events, mostly livestock, mostly equine. But at the end of the day, it's the youth activities that we do that define us. We spend about $1 million each year going to youth scholarship and education, whether it's helping youngsters in the third grade understand where their food comes from, or helping college-age youngsters find a way to go to college and scholarship. So what you're all doing here benefits that mission. We thank you very much. We hope you have a wonderful time. Not everybody can win, but good luck to all of you.
The cut of the rib is the cook's choice. Ribs turned in must include the bone. Internal temperature, according to USDA, 145 degrees, and allowed to rest for 3 minutes. You guys are all champions, and I think you're well familiar with these rules. Again, pork is defined as Boston butt, Boston roast, picnic, and or whole shoulder, weighing a minimum of 4 pounds at the time of inspection. After trimming pork, you'll be cooked whole, bone in, or bone out. However, once cooked, it may be separated and returned to the cooker at the cook's discretion. It may be turned in chopped, pulled, chunked, sliced, or any combination of both. The internal temperature, according to USDA, 145 degrees Fahrenheit, and allowed to rest for at least 3 minutes.
It's always hard, and we're trying to get things right. We know that we have a few glitches in the system, and we're going to tighten it up as we move forward. But we just so appreciate you being here and being patient with us as we figure this out. We are, I'm so short, they always think I need to stand on something. There I am. You know, I talked to all of you guys on the phone or via email, and Brady's around here running around too, and we feel like we know you. And then we get to meet you in person if we're not too busy, and it's incredible for us, and it's humbling that you give your time to come and support not only the barbecue, but our not-for-profit. So we are a not-for-profit organization that supports youth and education. Everyone, that's Brady. There he is. With the letter, and Elizabeth behind there. So if you've talked to either one of them, I know they've been incredibly helpful, but we start the wheels turning, and then it takes 500 volunteers this weekend to help us. So it is a humbling experience to stand in front of you and just to say thank you to you for being here, and thank you to the volunteers as well. We hope you have a good cook. We hope you've enjoyed the weather. We cooled it off a little bit for you, so that was nice. So there are no surprises. Fireworks will be going off again tonight at 11 o'clock. Had a few people scared last night, but all is well. Fireworks will go off, and we hope you guys have a great cook, and then join us for Big and Rich on the main stage. Everyone's invited to attend. Don't bring your lawn chairs. We just want to make sure we have enough room for everybody who's coming in, but we'll have some seating out there for you, and it's for everyone to enjoy, and just a way to say thank you for being here and for joining us and supporting our mission of teaching kids. We reach out to local schools and teach them about agriculture, where their food comes from, about proteins, about fruits, about vegetables. And we also have scholarships for children who are majoring in agriculture across the United States. So again, you guys make that happen. This is our biggest fundraiser. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you for being patient with us, and good luck today.
Okay, thank you, Kim. Certainly, folks, on behalf of the Kansas City Barbecue Society, we'd like to thank the American Royal Association for everything that they do for barbecue and everything that they do and that benefits society here in the Kansas City area, not only here, but throughout Missouri and Kansas. So thanks again on behalf of the Kansas City Barbecue Society. Let me introduce the teams that are the rep team that is working this event today. My name is Mike Lake. My wife, Teresa, is working it. Mark and Donna Simmons, Larry and Sharon Hadley, Kim and Mark Collier, Dennis and Linda Polson, and Steve and Scott Grinstead. That's your rep team that's working this particular event today. So if you see them guys, pat them on the back. You can't believe the work that committee goes through and this rep team goes through to help get this contest done. Remember that KCBS is here to make sure that you get a fair and impartial evaluation of your skills as a barbecue cook, and to make sure that the rules and regulations of the Kansas City Barbecue Society are followed. That is our function here this weekend. Turn-in times tomorrow. Chicken at noon. Ribs at 12:30. Pork at 1. Brisket at 1:30. And your sausage category at 2. Remember, you have a 10-minute window to get your product in. 5 minutes before the time I announce to 5 minutes after. If you're standing in line at the turn-in area, that is considered on time. Don't be running up the ramp, that is not considered on time. You have to be in line at the turn-in table. Okay, turn-ins. If you're cooking in this lot over here, which is commonly referred to as the invitational lot, you will go up the ramp here and turn in right behind those black curtains. For those of you that are cooking in the other lot, there's another ramp there. You're going to come up the ramp, and there'll be a black curtain up there down the hallway. That's where you will turn in. It's just a mirror of this room, only the reflection is opposite. So you'll be at that end, and the other one will be at this end.
Okay, I want all the Kansas Cityans to see that and make sure that you make these out-of-towners feel welcome and have a great experience. We're glad to have you here. I always ask judges to raise their right hand if they can taste the difference between a McRib sandwich and real barbecue. So if you can, and your right hand is raised, Please repeat after me. I do solemnly swear.
I solemnly swear.
To objectively and subjectively evaluate.
To objectively and subjectively evaluate.
Each barbecue meat.
Each barbecue meat.
That is presented.
That is presented.
To my eyes.
My eyes.
My nose.
My nose.
My hands.
My hands.
And my palate.
And my palate.
I accept my duty.
I accept my duty.
To be a 2015 36th Annual American Royal World Series of Barbecue Invitational Contest Judge. So that truth, justice, excellence in barbecue,
in
the American way of life, may be strengthened and preserved forever. You're on your oath. Do a great job.
My name is Stuart Downing. I'm from Germantown, Tennessee, and I got into barbecue through my dad at a very young age. My dad, Bruce, has been way into barbecue. He's been certified with Kansas City Barbecue Society and Memphis in May for I don't know how many years, but it seemed like more than a decade when I was turning 14, and that was actually when I got certified, was for my 14th birthday. My dad thought it would be a great birthday present for me. That, I guess, was when I was in eighth grade. I was starting to think about college as well, and he said, Stuart, you know, we were living in a suburb of Memphis, and he said, we'll take you up to Kansas City, get you certified right before the American Royal. He and his Bug Barbecue buddies were going up there as well, and I thought, you know, awesome. It sounded great. I loved Memphis barbecue for my entire life, but I had never really done any judging, and this was on my 14th birthday. We drove up to Kansas City, my first time to visit the city. It was wonderful. On the way up there, we visited University of Missouri. After the contest, we went up to Lawrence, visited KU for campus visits. But in Kansas City, I got certified at the class right before the Royal and judged a Royal the next day. That was, I guess, 2003. And at the age of 14, I had some comments that, you know, maybe I was the youngest. Was I the youngest? I don't know. But the next day, I judged, and it was wonderful. And I didn't really hear about it until the next month or so that they had created rules on age. I was technically under the new age. I believe it was 16 was the age they created the rule. But when my dad had the idea to give me this birthday present of being a barbecue judge, he had actually called ahead to Kansas City Barbecue Society and Memphis in May, the other society in Memphis, that asking, hey, you know, is there an age rule? And when he called ahead, they didn't really have an answer for him. They said, well, if you sign up for the class and bring them along, we'll see. Memphis in May called back and said, they kind of made one up. They said, there's a lot of beer flowing around this tournament. Maybe it'll be 21 years old. So turns out Memphis in May did later have a rule 18 years old, and that was also made after we asked, I think. But no, I got into barbecue through my dad, and he got me this gift and for my 14th birthday, and we've been coming back to the American Royal almost every year since then. This is my 26th birthday weekend. I just turned 26 yesterday, and that means, gosh, 12 years of barbecue judging. At my age, I think it's, wow, I'm pretty impressed. On average, sadly, because I've been busy with school, going to college up at the University of Missouri, which the first time I visited was because of barbecue, so thank you, barbecue, for sending me to University of Missouri. Really, on average, I'd say only about 2 contests a year, which is way too little for me. I'm still on my way to be becoming a master judge. And this is a real sticking point with me, is that I lost my certification book. You know the blue books where you write down all the contests. I have lost it recently in the past year or so, and it's kind of a little small panic for me. There's still an attic to search for in my house, but I don't know where it is, and I don't have any proof now that I am a really young certified judge. But
you're judging today?
No.
If you're not,
on average, 2 a year, and I really wish I did more, but usually it's this one, the American Royal.
I love you, but you gotta go.
Thank you. Get up, pair of scissors up. Right here behind you, though. Into the top drawer.
Cut that tin off right there. Go this way, right there.
Favorite chicken was number four. It had a great flavor, it had a great appearance, and it was just real juicy and flavorful. My least favorite was number five. The appearance was just a little off. The coloring was just, there was just something about it. Plus, it just had a flavor that I couldn't address, and it was extremely dry.
For appearance, they all were pretty good. Number one was very tender, very tasty. Number two was not as tender, but tasty. The one I liked the least was the third one, a little chewy. And on the last one, the taste was not what I'm used to. I'm told it's cloves.
Just comment on each one of them. Yeah, my favorite this round for the chicken was definitely number one and number two. The first one, though I had an inconsistent bite on either side, I still scored it well. The flavor was really good. Number two, that was my all-around favorite off the plate. I thought it was cooked properly. I liked the flavor. It was just a nice piece of chicken. Number three lacked flavor for me. It didn't have a lot of smoke. It just didn't fit what I think the parameters are for a good piece of KCBS chicken. Number four was okay. That was a decent piece of chicken. It had a flavor in there I couldn't quite pick out, and that affected me a little bit on the taste. And the fifth one, I wasn't a big fan of. It was cooked all right. It just had a strange flavor, strange glaze.
For me, I liked one and two the best. I found two had a really good chicken flavor, but the skin flap came off quite easily, where the other ones were quite intact. So it was a bit uncomfortable, but the taste overall was very good. And I found the tenderness just a little bit slightly less than my number one choice. Number one seemed to have the overall consistent balance between sweetness and spice. Number three seemed to be over-injected. I had a strong fat taste to it as opposed to a chicken flavor to it, so it was probably my least favorite. And number four, overall it was generally very good, not as good as one and two, but I still liked it very much. Taste wise it had a bit of a harsh green smoke to it, which was a little uncomfortable, but other than that it was a very good piece of chicken. And number five, it was unbalanced. It was a little large and a little bit tight on the chew, but mostly the sweet spices were unbalanced and very prominent, making the dish a little bit uncomfortable on the palate.
I actually enjoyed number one and number four. Number five, not so much. It had a different flavor to it. Didn't care too much for it. And also was a little bit lighter than what I would like.
I liked one and two. They both had very good mouthfeel. Number one had a little bit more sauce than I care for. And number two really had a good smoky flavor. I like that a lot. Number four was good. Number five was a first for me in my career. It had a huge pocket of grease, and that was a very, very bad mouthfeel. And then finally, another first for me, the chicken had clove in the sauce. So while the chicken itself, you know, was tender enough, that really was an offsetting flavor, ruined the meat flavor. And beyond that, the chicken was a little bit rubbery, so didn't look good in appearance, nor did it taste good in the texture.
Shedding five and five, loaded up.
Sorry, number five.
Because?
The taste was excellent, and it was tender but not overcooked. They were all so good, it was hard to pick a least favorite, maybe number one. I found it to be slightly overcooked.
Out of the five, I chose number five to be the best, and number one to be more overcooked.
Because?
Oh, I liked five because of the taste.
I enjoyed the best, probably number five. Number two was a close second for me. And probably the least was number one. Taste was good, but just not quite cooked to perfection.
I would say number four was my favorite. Had a little bit more kick to it, a little bit more taste. Number one was a little too sweet, but it wasn't bad. And number three was overcooked. The whole meat came right off the bone.
For me, number one was definitely the least favorite. Number three, I thought three, my sample of three was good. It wasn't overcooked. It was right on. And four were good. Five to me was, my number five was a little over.
My favorite sample is number two. Best flavor, cooked great. Least favorite was, again, number five because it was overdone.
Fill that box. Good luck.
I liked, the one I liked the least was number five here because it was too hot. The rest of them are all pretty good. I thought number one was okay. Number three was good. Everything was good except I'm just too hot for me, number five.
Okay. This is a really good mic, so you don't have to talk.
Yeah. The one that I liked the best was number four because it was tender and didn't have a lot of sauce to it, and I could taste the flavor in it. The least one I liked was number three. It was a little tough. And the rest of them, they was pretty good, but number four was the best.
Each and every one, of course, was a great representation of the fine art of barbecue cookers and smokers. Each and every one was outstanding in its own way.
I did. They're all great.
I like number three the best. I actually thought it was tender and had the best flavor. And number five was dry and it was too spicy.
I agree. I like number three the best. And number five was too salty.
I like number four the best. Thought it was cooked very well, had great flavor. I also like the last one, but I know for some people it's probably a little bit too spicy. But and then number three was just a little bit dry and tough, but it's very, very good pork overall.
Can you hand me my scissors? I have scissors in there.
Here?
Yep. Uh-oh.
Are you sure they're in here?
Scissors?
They might be in the sink.
Go look in the sink.
It's a bit, keep going. You can fix that. Yeah, okay. Just keep going. I'm not so worried about the bottom one, it's the top one that needs a tad of attention.
I enjoyed the brisket in number five. I enjoyed the flavor of it. I think the taste was one of the best tastes on the plate. I thought that while the taste of number three was quite good, the texture was a little off, and it had places where I felt it was not cooked as well as it could have been. Perhaps a little overcooked and still keeping the a lot of the fat up top was presented a texture taste in my mouth that it wasn't pleasing.
I liked the number five especially, and the least one I really didn't like was number one. I can't tell you, the taste was off. It didn't have the smoke taste that I was looking for.
My favorite was number one. The tenderness was just perfect, had a nice chew. I could taste beef, smoke, and whatever accented the flavor. I didn't, so that was my favorite.
Least favorite?
Least favorite was number three, too mushy.
Well, my favorite was actually number four. I thought it had a real good tenderness, it had a real good flavor to it. My least favorite, it was a toss-up between two and three. Number two is really tough to chew, hard to tear apart. Number three, ton of fat on top of it, and it was pretty well overcooked. So,
my favorite was number one. I thought it was a good texture, good taste, smoky. My least favorite was number three. It was a little too peppery, a little mushy.
Okay, out of the five, my favorite was number four. I had, in my opinion, had the best beef flavor, a tad on the salty side. My least favorite was number three, a little heavy on the fat. But all around it was real good. There were some good cooks.
Thank you all very much.
What was it? Mushroom. It was pretty good. Mushroom, pretty good. Coleslaw is pretty good.
Okay.
Stuffed mushroom was good. Stuffed mushroom was good. Coleslaw is good.
Stuffed mushroom, it was okay. Stuffed mushroom, it was pretty good. And the coleslaw, and it was pretty good.
Stuffed mushroom was pretty good. Stuffed mushroom was very good. Coleslaw was pretty good.
The first stuffed mushroom was good. Could have been a little bit more tender, but it was good. The second one was perfect on the tenderness and tasted pretty good. And the coleslaw was okay. It just didn't have much flavor. So that's the only thing I could say about that.
I didn't care for any of it.
Oh, okay. That's fine. I just, it's all about taste.
Yep.
Thank you.
Number one, nicely presented, a little sugary. Number two, tasted like canned beans to me. Number three, very good, multiple different kinds of beans and spices. Number four, good flavor, like the bacon. Number five,
unbelievable. Spicy, hot, excellent.
Number one was really good, really sweet, and had a good smoke flavor. I thought the bacon was maybe a little overcooked. Number two was a little too soupy for my liking. Had some good flavors, but just didn't jump out at me. Number three was really good. I liked the different kinds of beans that were in it. Number four, lots of bacon, which is always a plus. And number five was my favorite. Good smoky flavor, spicy like I like it, and just overall a really good bean.
Number one had nice bacon flavor, but just kind of regular beans. Number two was almost like canned beans, not a lot of flavor. Number three, nice onion flavor at the end, really well done. Number four, excellent job. Bacon with some really great beans in it. And number five, super job, stupendous job, especially with the pork belly in it.
I liked number one's presentation a lot. It was sweet, which I like. A lot of bacon, which is great. Number two, didn't see a lot of flavor, and I thought the pepper actually distracted from the flavor a lot because it kind of mixed all together. Three, I liked all of the different little chunks and surprises in there. A lot of good textures, lots of different flavors to kind of keep you interested. The number four was a little tomato-y for me, but the bacon was fantastic in it. And number five was good and smoky, but that's kind of overpowering to the other flavors. So I would say that number one was probably my favorite.
I thought number one was very good. I liked the bacon in it, good smoke flavor, sweet. Overall, beans were cooked right. Tender and very, very tasty. Number two did nothing for me. Tasted like it was honestly poured out of a can. It just did not. Pinot beans and juice, it just was not tasty. Three was complex. Garlic with a lot of different flavors. Very good smoke. Ate like a meal, and it was very complex and good. Good smoke flavor as well. Good bean. Number four, average, not a lot of flavor. Beans were a little mushy. Bacon was good, but not much. Five was very, very good. Eight, almost like a chili. It was good smoke. Had kick to it, which I like. Presented very well. It was very good. Overall, just a very good, good bean presentation and dish.
Number one, I thought was pretty delicious, nice, sweet, smoky flavor to it. Number two was very one note, very generic, did not have a whole lot of flavor to it. Three was easily my favorite, lots of textures, lots of flavors, definitely the best of the bunch, a lot of stuff going on there. Number four, the beans were a little firm for my liking. The bacon was nice. The flavors were okay, but the beans, like I said, just a bit firm. Number five was also very delicious. Enjoyed the meat skewer with it, and the flavors were very, very good.
Thank you all very much.
Back in 2006, my name is Kyle Smith. Back in 2006, I was a U.S. Marine serving with 1st Light Armored Reconnaissance Battalion. I was barbecuing a lot for the Marines in my barracks. We had just returned from Iraq, and my barbecues grew in size from a fire team to a squad to a platoon, and finally most of my company was coming. I got overwhelmed. I sent Mr. Reichlin here an email, and he, in return, sent me just a huge plethora of supplies. He sent me both of the books he had on the market at the time. He had even put post-it notes on the pages that I could probably do pretty quickly for my Marines. And on behalf of 1st Light Armored Reconnaissance Battalion, I wanted to always thank you, sir.
What am I supposed to say? Hoorah, right?
Hoorah!
Yeah, thank you. That's very great.
2015 Barbecue Hall of Fame Induction Ceremony. My name is Kim Palmer, and I am with the American Royal, and I am proud to share the stage with these incredible barbecue icons. Each year, the American Royal World Series of Barbecue pauses to honor the history of barbecue and the legends that have paved the way. I'd like to thank you all for taking the moments to step away from your barbecue pits to join us as we induct and celebrate the newest members to the Barbecue Hall of Fame. In 2012, under the leadership and guidance of Mr. Bob Peterson, CEO and President of the American Royal, we proudly became the home of the Barbecue Hall of Fame. Tonight, we continue the tradition, and I am honored to introduce our Master of Ceremonies for the evening, Mr. Bob Peterson.
Thank you, Kim Palmer. I hope my voice holds up. I've been talking too much. I've been breathing too much barbecue. It's wonderful. Let me say thank you to Kim Palmer and her assistant, Brady Madsen. They've done an awesome job. They have worked so hard, folks, to have this organized, to pull everything together. Huge undertaking in the first year to change venues. So thank you, Kim. Thank you, Brady. And welcome to the 2015 American Royal World Series of Barbecue Hall of Fame induction ceremony. As you know, we are a nonprofit, and this barbecue weekend, along with the other events that we host throughout the season, help us raise money for scholarships for youth and education. The Hall of Fame is a very special thing to us. It's special because of the people and the friendships and the relationships and those that we have honored who have gone before them. And as I've gone through the grounds today, I've been in this job 5 years, I feel like I'm starting to get to know many of you. It's a wonderful, special community that has come together to honor these three people who have accomplished such a body of lifetime of work that we're thrilled to be part of. As Kim mentioned, in 2012, the American Royal became the official home of the Barbecue Hall of Fame. It exists to recognize and preserve the heritage of barbecue in our world. It honors the evolving history and traditions of barbecue, and keeping in line with the American Royal's purpose of supporting children and education, the Hall of Fame exists to educate about barbecue. Barbecue's top honor is being elected to the Barbecue Hall of Fame.
Yeah.
These inductees tonight are chosen and honored from three different categories: business and industry, pit master, and celebrity humanitarian.
Well, my name is Ed Fisher, and about 40 years ago, I took this clay cooker that I had brought back with me from Japan, and I figured I could make it a little bit better, and worked on it a while, and figured we might sell a few, gave it a name, didn't know what to call it at first, but it was big and looked like an egg, and it was green, so I called it the Big Green Egg. And here I am, 40 years later, and I'm honored to be in the company of such giants in the barbecued world, such as Paul Kirk.
Yeah, bring my weight into it, Ed.
and Steve Rickland.
Great. And I'm Stephen Reichlin, and I'm absolutely thrilled with the honor of being inducted into the Barbecue Hall of Fame. I'm a little bit different than everybody in this world. This was not my world, barbecue. I actually have a degree in French literature. And 20 years ago, this crazy idea popped into my head, and that is, wouldn't it be amazing to travel around the world and document how people grill and smoke in different countries? And so I embarked on this journey, and the result was a book called The Barbecue Bible. And that led me into the world of barbecue, and I've been doing it ever since. I've written 8 books. I've made 4 TV series. I have explored barbecue everywhere from Bali, Indonesia to Burbank, California. And every day I thank my lucky stars that I have discovered barbecue and barbecue has discovered me.
My name is Paul Kirk. I'm known as Kansas City Baron of Barbecue. This will be my 35th American Royal. I missed the first one, didn't know it was happening. It's been a long run, it's been a fun run, and I too am very proud to be inducted in the Barbecue Hall of Fame. Other than that, I've cooked, I've helped written or co-authored 12 cookbooks, all in barbecue. I love what I do, I love to teach it, and that's primarily what I do is teach barbecue.
My favorite, it looked good, and it also tasted very good. The texture was very good, very tender, had a nice light smoky flavor. My least favorite did not look that well. It had an off flavor, and it was almost like a dirty grill.
I like number one the best because it had good flavor and good texture. Good looking machine. Then number four I thought was kind of the worst one of the bunch. It didn't have any flavor and it was a little overdone on the crust.
Number one was clearly the best. Good taste, good texture, tender, bite through skin. Flavor was just right. Didn't have a lot of back heat on it. And four was looked like a mess, tasted like a mess, didn't make the grade.
My favorite was number one, great taste, nice and tender, and my worst was number four, just looked like it had been burnt and it had no taste.
My favorite was number six. It was very juicy, had well textured, and number four was by far the worst because of looked burnt, didn't have very good skin on it.
My favorite was one and six. They were both juicy. The taste was great. The sauce was good too. And our four was charred and had a bad taste, so that was the worst.
I thought number two was the best, had good flavor, and it was tender.
I felt number two as well was the best. It had good flavor and great texture. Number five was my least favorite because of a strange spice on it.
Yeah, I thought number two was a real good rib, real meaty, but still real tender. And number three I thought was a good rib, but I liked a little extra sauce on it as well, a little overcooked. I liked that.
And number two was the best, had a good flavor, real tender. Number six was extremely tough.
I like number one the best. You know, it had good flavor, and mine was pretty tender. And number three, I didn't care for number three. It was a little tough, and the flavor just wasn't there for me.
Number two is my favorite. Number four, I don't know what they did. They caramelized it just right. That one had just the right flavor. I like number four also.
All right. Thank you, gentlemen.
I like number one the best. It had the porkiest flavor to me and had the best chew in your mouth and just tasted really what the criteria said that pork should taste like. The least favorite for me is going to be number five there. They put a lot of sauce on the one chunk that I had there that sort of drowned out the flavor, and it was a little on the mushier side.
My favorite was number three. I thought it was just a very well-balanced, smoky, flavorful, what I would expect from a from pork. And I believe number five was also my least favorite. To me, it was just a little on the dry side.
My favorite was number one. I thought it had a good taste, good flavor, good texture to it. And number five was just, I don't know, there was something about it that just didn't taste as good as what I thought it should be. And the tenderness wasn't there.
Number one was my favorite. It had a good smoke flavor, had good tenderness, a good barbecue taste. And number six was overcooked and no flavor at all.
Likewise, my favorite was the first one. It done well, seasoned well, tasted good, and six was, again, overcooked and no taste.
My favorite one was number one, had good flavor. I liked the bark on it. My least favorite was number two. I thought it didn't have any flavor. And number three, was kind of a tale of two cities for me. They turned in money muscle that was really tough, and then the pull that they turned in was overcooked. So they had both ends of the spectrum, but I would go with one as the best.
I like number one. Nice tender pull to it. Tasted good. Least like this one. Tough, sort of bland.
I liked number five. It was very tender, had a great flavor. I did not care for number six. It had an unusual flavor.
I liked number five, and I disliked number three. It was very tough.
I love number five. The flavor is amazing. Number three, I could barely bite it. It was so tough.
I like number two. I like the flavor of the bark, and it was tender. I dislike number three because it was tough.
I like number one. It was my favorite, and number six was my worst, I thought.